Hey there, welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Tutcast.com. Last night was a pretty historic night. Not only did Barack Obama become elected the next president of the United States of America, but CNN introduced its first live hologram. Now I figured I'd jump on that bandwagon and combine both of them and create the Obamagram. You know, Barack Obama, hologram, Obamagram. Anyways. We're going to begin by finding a picture of Barack Obama. Go to Google or image search Barack Obama, and I believe this was the first or second picture there. Then you need to find a background image. Now you can use any background you want. You can use any person you want. You can use yourself, you can use your mother, you can use your father, or Barack Obama, John McCain, whatever you want, and any background image. Just make sure that both images are approximately the same size, so when you drag the subject matter over top of the background, you don't have to do much resizing, and it'll fit pretty nicely. So, here we go. We're going to begin by making our selection. We want to single out Barack Obama from the background that he's on right now. And you can use any method you want. You can use the magic wand tool, the lasso tool, the pen tool. If you're on Photoshop CS3, you can use the extract filter. Now, I will note one quick thing. I am using Photoshop CS4 in this tutorial, but I'll do my best to make sure it's achievable in previous versions of Photoshop. Now I went ahead and used my magic wand tool, which is a very simple tool to use, and I made my selection as you can see here. You can tell by the little marching ants going around Barack Obama and the background. Now I'm going to very simply feather out this selection and expand it just a little bit by going to Select, Modify, Expand. I'm going to expand it by one pixel. Or a pickle, whatever you want to call it. Select, modify, and then feather, and just feather it out a radius of around 2 pixels. Click OK and press delete, and that will single out Barack Obama from the background, getting rid of everything else. And now we can go ahead and very simply drag this image on top of our background image, just like this, and I'm going to offset it to the left just a little bit. Now, if you take a look at the videos or images of the CNN hologram, the woman who was the hologram had a little bit of a bluish tint to her. And this can be achieved by adding a photo filter. Now, it can be done one of two ways, either using an adjustment layer or directly on top of the layer. We're going to be adding an adjustment layer so it's non-destructive and it can be changed later on. So in our layers palette, we're going to hold down Command or Control and click on our Barack Obama layer to make him a selection. And then at the bottom, we're going to click on the black and white icon and then click on Photo Filter. Now, if you're on Photoshop CS4, it's going to bring up the Adjustments Layers panel. If you're on Photoshop CS3, it's going to bring up a brand new dialog box. The settings will be the same. Under Filter, we're going to change it to Cooling Filter 82, and Density is going to be set to around 50%, just like that. And that will give Barack Obama a nice cool tint to him, a nice blue tint. It looks a little bit more hologram-ish. So here we go. We're going to add a few more things. We're going to bring back up our layers palette. We're going to double click on the Barack Obama layer, which will bring up our layer styles dialog box. We're going to decrease the opacity just a little bit. Now this hologram is going to be a little bit different than the one that CNN did. The one that CNN did, trying to make it look as realistic as possible. We're going to really make this look like a hologram. So we're going to decrease the opacity to somewhere around 80%. And we're going to add a nice blue outer glow. So we're going to change the blend mode to hard light. We're going to change the color to a nice blue color right up here. And we're going to increase the range just like this and the size. And then decrease the opacity so it's not too bright, just like that, and click OK. Now it's looking somewhat holographic, but there's one more thing that we're going to do to make it look even better, make it look like it's a transmission. We're going to create a new document by going to File, New, and the dimensions are going to be 4 pixels by 4 pixels. Now this seems a little bit insane, but we're actually going to be making a pattern, a scan line pattern. We're going to click OK. And we're going to zoom all the way in here, just like this. And we're going to fill this with black. Why? You'll get to that in a second. We're going to fill it with black and then create a new layer by clicking on the new layer icon at the bottom. In this new layer, we're going to grab our pencil tool, which is right over here. We're going to make sure that the brush size is set to 1 and the color is set to white. And very simply, we're going to color the top half of this 4 pixel by 4 pixel box. So we can only see the white and then our background layer. And very simply, hide the background layer. That was just because when we zoom in very close, we can't really see the transparency. So we make the background layer black just so we can see it on the white. So we're gonna hide the background layer and then go to Edit, Define Pattern, and I'm gonna name it White Scan Line and click OK. That's it. Now we're gonna go back to our document that we're working on. We're going to select Barack Obama once again by holding down Command or Control and clicking on him. We're gonna create a new layer, just like that. And then heading over to our Tools palette, grab our Paint Bucket tool, then grab at the top, not foreground, but pattern, and then select your white scan lines pattern. And very simply click inside the selection, just like that. And now I'm going to zoom in here just so you can see what's going on. And very simply, I'm going to smooth out the edges of our scan lines by going to Select, Modify, Feather, enter a value of 10 pixels, click OK, select Inverse, and then delete 1, 2, 3 times, and then deselect. That just smooths out those edges just a little bit. And now to blend it all together, we're going to go to our Layers palette, click on where it says Normal to bring up our blending options, and then select Overlay. That'll blend them very nicely, and you can play with the opacity if you want. And we are left with a pretty nice holographic result. Now, it's not perfect. Take a look at some holographs on Google, and then adjust the settings to your likings. You can always go back in our photo filter, our adjustment layer, adjust those accordingly. We can add some more adjustment layers to play with the settings and the color. But we do have a pretty nice result, and yes, I notice I'm using a background from the 2004 election, but don't pay attention to that. But what I want you guys to do is watch the tutorial again if you have to, and upload your version of a hologram that you created in Photoshop. It doesn't have to be a presidential one, but it can be anything you want. Apply these techniques and apply some of your own techniques and upload it to YouTube, post it as a video response, and make sure to comment and rate this video. And also subscribe to our RSS feed at tutcast.com. We're always releasing tutorials earlier than we are on YouTube. We're going to be having some really exclusive tutorials on Tutcast very shortly. And until next time, this is Howard from tutcast.com. Take care.